We are soldiers in the army. We got to fight, although we have to die. We gonna hold on the gospel banner. We gonna hold it up until we die. We are soldiers in the army. We got to fight, although we
Revelation chapter 14 from verse 6 to verse what? To verse 12. The first angel's message was holding in what? An everlasting gospel. To preach to what? To preach to the world. It was calling people to worship the God who made the heaven and what? And the earth. So we try to touch about those aspects of worshiping the God who made what? The heaven and what? And the earth. Yesterday we were talking about Babylon and the wine of what? Of Babylon. You are going to find out that the message of today is the continuation of yesterday's what? Message. Because these messages, these angels, they are following what? Each other. It's one after what? Another. There is first angel's message, second angel's message, and third angel's what? Message. So, from today and tomorrow, we are going to change the gears. We are going to change what? We are going to change gears. We're driving number two. From today we are going to number what? Number three. Tomorrow we'll go number four. Sabbath will be finishing here. So may God be with you. May God bless you. I wish you to be with you until to the end of this what? Of this presentation. So we are changing gears today. The reason why we are changing gears, it's because of the message. Verse 9 of Revelation, chapter 14, is changing what? It's changing the gear. It's changing gears. What does it say in verse 9? And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand. This is the third angel's message. Followed them, saying with a loud voice. This message, it must be preached with a what? A loud voice. It means it's a what? It's a warning. That is why the message is, the angel is preaching in what? In a loud voice. It's a warning to the what? To the world. It's an alarm to the what? To the world. Saying what? If any man worship the beast. It means in the last days, people are going to worship what? The beast of Revelation. So God is warning the people not to worship what? the beast and his what? His image, and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand. So the first angel's message, while he is calling people to worship God, the Creator, and his mark of creation, this beast is calling people to worship him and his mark. So there are a group of people in the last days who are going to have the mark of the what? Of the beast. So there is two groups in these last days. We can have many churches, but there is two what? There is two groups. We can have many churches, but the reality is there is two gods. Either you worship God the Creator, or you worship the beast of Revelation. So how bad is this message? That's why we have to preach it. What is happening to those who are going to worship the beast and mark of the beast? Verse 10, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the what? Of the Lamb. Verse 11. And the smoke of their torment ascended up forever and ever, and they have no rest day nor night, who worship what? The beast and his image, and whosoever receiveth the mark of his name. So this is the message of today. Today we are going to talk about this beast of Revelation. Who is this beast of Revelation? Tomorrow we are going to talk about the mark of the beast and the image of the beast and the name of the what? Of the beast. So today we are going to introduce this what? This beast. But tomorrow we are going to touch about the mark of the beast, the image of the beast, and the name of the what? Of the beast. So who is this beast of Revelation? We cannot understand this beast until we understand the book of what? Of Daniel. In order to understand the book, the beast of Revelation, we have to understand the beast of what? Of Daniel. Before God gave this message to John the Revelator, he gave it to what? To who? To Daniel the prophet. Are you getting the sense?
Yes.
So the book of Daniel was sealed, and the book of Revelation was revealed, was opened. So the book of Daniel and Revelation is like part A and part B. It's like the roots and the tree. Are you getting the sense? It's like the lock and the key to unlock the what? The lock. So many people today, they don't understand the book of Daniel and the book of Revelation. Even many churches, these books, many people, they are not reading them. They are saying it's difficult to understand what? The book of Daniel and the book of Revelation. But let me tell you the secret. God gave us the book of Revelation to open the book of what? Of Daniel. Let us go to the book of Daniel. If you go to the last chapter of the book of Daniel, chapter 12, even Daniel himself, he didn't understand the book of what? Of Daniel. Verse 9. And he said, go thy way, Daniel. Let us start from verse 8. And I heard, but I understood not. Daniel the prophet, he didn't understand the message of the book of what? Of Daniel. He is saying here, I heard about it, but I didn't understand what? The message. Then said I, oh my Lord, what shall be the end of these things? When God gave Daniel the prophets of this beast, Daniel didn't understand what the message. He was confused himself. He was confused. And he asked God to understand the book of what? Of Daniel. And God replied in verse 9. And he said, "Go thy way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed till the time of the end." Then God said to Daniel, "Daniel, it's time for you to go. You have to what? To move. This book is what? Is sealed. Read the last verse, verse 13. But go thou thy way till the end be, for thou shalt rest and stand in thy Lord at the end of the days." God said to Daniel, "It's time for you to what? To go. You shall die. You shall rest, not understanding this prophecy." I don't understand it. But God promised Daniel that, "But in the last day, you shall what? You shall stand." It means Daniel, he shall understand these things in the millennium time. It's when he shall have to understand it fully. So Daniel died not understanding the book of what? Of Daniel. But there is a promise here of understanding the book of who? Of Daniel. God said here, "The book shall be opened in the time of what? Of end." Verse 9. And he said, "Go thy way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed till the time of the what? Of the end." The book of Daniel was sealed, but not forever. Was sealed until the time of the what? Of the end. Is this the time of the end? Are we living in the time of the end? God gave Daniel the signs of the times of the end before Jesus Christ gave it on Matthew chapter 24. Yeah. On the very same book of Daniel chapter 12, go with me to Daniel chapter 4. "But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the what? The book, even to the time of the end." So God told Daniel to seal what? The book, to close the book, until to the time of what? Of the end. What are the signs to show us that this is the time of the end, to open the what? The book. Continue with the verse. "Many shall run to and fro, and the knowledge shall be increased." You see two signs of the time of the end. Number one, many shall run to and what? And fro. Number two, knowledge shall what? Shall increase. Are we in the time of the end? In the time of Daniel, it was difficult for people to run to and fro. It was difficult because means of transport in the days of Daniel, it was very tough. It was not easy. Means of transport was camels, horses, and donkeys. That was the means of what? Of transport. It was difficult for people to run to and fro. Means of transport there was ships, was boats. That was the means of transport. It was not easy for people to run what? To and fro. To cross country, it was difficult in the days of what? Of Daniel. But today, people are not running to and fro. Zimbabweans are not in South Africa. Nigerians are not in South Africa. Chinese are not in South Africa. Many tribes are in what? In South Africa. People shall run to and what? To and fro. With different reasons. Some is because of economic situations. Some is because of politics. Some is because of businesses. People are running what? To and fro. Today, we have bicycles. We have motorbikes. We have cars. We have aeroplanes. Back then, for people to run to and fro, it was difficult.
people to travel and journey, it would take days, months, and years. It can take how many days from South Africa to Nigeria? It can take some months. But today, with aeroplane, it can take how long? It's somewhat some hours. People shall run to and what? To and fro. Are we living in the last days whereby people are running all over the world? Borders are opening 24 hours. People are running all over the what? The world. People are all over the world. Tribes are being mixing. Some are in China, some are in Europe. Everywhere you can find many tribes. People are running what? To and fro. And knowledge shall what? Shall increase. In the days of Daniel, knowledge was less. Means of communication in the time of Daniel was to write letters. That was the means of what? Of communication. But today, knowledge is what? Increasing. Then phones came, started by landlines. Then cell phones came, like this one. Today we have touch screens. Our goggles, they are on WhatsApp today. Knowledge shall what? Shall increase. This is the sign of the what? Of the last days. Knowledge of technology. Even knowledge of knowing the word of what? Of God. That's why this message must what? Must be preached. We can talk about television. We can talk about computers. We are living in the days of what? Of knowledge today. Whereby we have Uncle Google. Anything you can want, you can ask what, you can ask who? Uncle Google. Knowledge shall what? Increase. God told Daniel, if knowledge is increased, if people are running to and fro, this is the right time to open the what? The book. So this is the right time to open the what? The book. So we can go to Daniel chapter 7 in order for us to understand the book of Revelation. So we are going to connect the book of Daniel and the book of what? Of Revelation. Daniel had a dream on Daniel chapter 7. Verse 1. In the first year of Belshazzar, king of Babylon, Daniel had a dream and visions of his head upon his bed. Then he wrote the dream and told the sum of the matters. Verse 2. Daniel spake and said, I saw in my vision by night, and behold, the four winds of the heavens strove upon the great sea. And the four great beasts came up from the sea, diverse one from another. Then God gave the prophets of the beast first to Daniel the prophet. So Daniel, in his vision, he saw forward beast, diverse from what? From one another. So the first beast was like a what? Was like a lion. And the second beast was like a what? Like a bear. And the third beast was like a what? Like a leopard with four heads. And the fourth beast was difficult to describe. Daniel couldn't find in any zoo in the world animal like this in the world. So Daniel just prescribed the beast as it he saw. So Daniel chapter 7 is the same with Daniel chapter 2. So before God gave this prophecy of the beast to Daniel chapter 7, he first gave this prophecy on Daniel chapter 2. First to King who? To King Nebuchadnezzar. But he gave this prophecy in another form of a what? Of a statue, of an image, like a what? Like a man. On Daniel chapter 2. So if you go to Daniel chapter 2, God gave to Daniel this prophecy to King Nebuchadnezzar, and Daniel interpreted the dream. But on Daniel chapter 7 is the same prophecy like on Daniel chapter 2. But on Daniel chapter 7, it has some added what details. Are you getting the sense? So on Daniel chapter 2, it's a statue of a metal. So this image on Daniel chapter 2, it was the head was the head of what? Of gold. The chest was the chest of what? Of silver. And the waist and thighs was of what? Of bronze. And the legs was legs of what? Of iron. And the foot and the toes was iron mixed with what? With clay. But on Daniel chapter 2, it was four what? Beasts. The first beast was like a what? A lion. The second beast was a bear. The third beast was a leopard. The fourth beast was a what? Was a dragon. But on that same fourth beast, it had what? 10 horns, which is like the foot of clay mixed with what? With iron. 10 toes. So you can take these verses on Daniel chapter 2. Then on Daniel chapter 7, these are the verses. So the first beast symbolizes what? The kingdom of Babylon. Why I am saying this? The Bible must interpret what? Itself. Go with me to 2 Peter chapter 1. 2 Peter chapter 1 from verse 19. 2 Peter chapter 1 from verse 19. We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well that ye take heed, as unto a light that shineth in a dark place until the day dawn. Peter said, we have a sure word of what? Of prophecy. So we cannot get lost in this word of what? Of prophecy. So Daniel and Revelation are the sure word of what? Of prophecy. Verse 20. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. So this prophecy, the church must not interpret this prophecy. I must not interpret this prophecy. Pastor or prophet must not interpret this what? Prophecy. Because this prophecy have no private what? Interpretation. What does it mean? It means the Bible must interpret itself. I'm not here to interpret the prophets of Revelation and of Daniel. But I am here to help each other, the Bible, to interpret what? Itself. The Bible must interpret itself. The reason why, verse 21. For the prophets came not in old time by the will of men, but the holy men of God spake as they were moved by the holy what? The Holy Ghost. So God gave the prophets through the what? The Holy Ghost. This Bible, it didn't come with what? With men. It's God who what? Who brought this word of what? Of prophecy. So God must interpret his what? His word. What does it mean? It means the Bible must be its dictionary for itself. Are you getting sense? If we had a question about the beast of Daniel Revelation, we don't go to pastor. We don't go to dictionary. We go back to the Bible and ask what the Bible. To say there is the beast here. What is what? What is the beast? There is mark of the beast here. What is the what? The mark of the beast. So it's not about the church. It's not about me. The Bible must what? Must speak. The Bible must what? Must speak. Must speak. Go with me to Isaiah chapter 34. Isaiah chapter 34, verse 16. Isaiah 34, verse 16. Isaiah 34, verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord, and read. No one of these shall fail. None shall want him it. For my mouth it hath commanded, and his spirit it hath gathered them. Seek ye in the word of what? Of God. You shall find what? Everything. So we have to seek in the word of what? Of God. On the same very book, chapter 28, verse 10. Isaiah 28, verse 10. For precept must be upon what? Precept. Precept upon what? Precept. Line upon what? Line. Line upon what? Line. Here a little, and there what? A little. Verse 13. But the word of the Lord was unto them, precept upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line. Here a little, and there what? A little. So if we start the Bible, we don't stand with verse 1. To say the beast of Revelation is a computer. The beast of Revelation is what and what? We must study the word of God. Here a little and there what? A little. From the Old Testament to New Testament, then we gather the verses which talks about what? The beast of Revelation. Then we can come with the answer of the beast of who? Of Revelation. So Daniel 7, let's go back to this beast. Daniel 7, let's go to verse 17. Daniel 7, verse 17. Who is this beast of Daniel and Revelation? Daniel 7, verse 17. This great beast, which are four kings which shall rise out of the earth. We are interpreting the beast now. God told Daniel that these four great beasts you saw are four kings which shall rise upon what? The earth. So in the Bible, when it's talking about the beast of Daniel and Revelation, it's not talking about animals in the jungle. These beasts are what? Are kings. So this beast of Revelation is a king. Or a kingdom. So what is this kingdom in the last days? Revelation 14, verse 9. Which are being worshipped with people. In the what? In the last days. So these four beasts are kings. What does it mean? It means from the first beast to the last beast, until Jesus comes, there shall be only what? Four beasts. It means there shall be only what? Four kingdoms. And the fifth kingdom, is the kingdom of who? Of Jesus Christ. It means after these kings, we shall going to be in the kingdom of who? Of Jesus Christ. So, this beast of Revelation is the fourth beast. It means it's the last beast to rule all over the world until Jesus who comes. So we are going to trace this fourth what beast. But we can start from the first what beast. So the first beast or the first kingdom was the kingdom of who? Of Babylon. Which was like a what? A lion. Which ruled from 605 BC to 5 38, 539 what? BC. It's Daniel chapter 7, verse 4. The second beast, like a bear, it represented the kingdom of what? Of Medo-Persia. Those who did history, now we are talking about world history or European what? History. So when we are talking about this kingdom, we are not talking about small kingdoms. We are not talking about Zambia or Zimbabwe or South Africa. We are talking about superpowers, world powers like America. Babylon ruled the whole world. It was the superpower. It was controlling the whole world universe. Medo-Persia ruled what? The whole world. Darius and Cyrus, they were controlling the what? The whole world. Then after Medo-Persia, in 331 BC, we get into the kingdom of what? Of Greece. Those who did history, history agrees with the Bible. Are we there? If we don't understand the Bible, we can go back to what? To history. History can tell us what? The truth. The true history can agree with what? The Bible. If your history doesn't agree with the Bible, it means it's a false what? History. Because a prophet, it's a history. It's a history before it has been fulfilled. Are you getting it? That is a prophet. When the prophet is fulfilled, it's now a what? A history. So in this prophet, we have a prophet which is now a history. Like Babylon is now a history. But in the time of Daniel, it was a what? A prophet. Daniel, the kingdom of Babylon passed away. The kingdom of Medo-Persia passed away. The kingdom of Greece passed away. From 331 BC, Alexander the Great ruled. It's in what? In the history of today. Until 168 BC. After the year 68 BC, we get into the kingdom of the Roman what? Empire. This is the fourth what? The fourth beast, or the first kingdom, or the first what? Or the fourth what? Or the fourth power. These are the first. What is happening with our?
That's what I spoke about.
Sorry?
It's that era I spoke about.
So, let me give you these verses. Daniel 2, verse 4, Daniel 7, verse 7, 8, Luke 2, verse 1. Roman Empire ruled from 168 BC to 476 AD. This is the fourth beast. The fifth kingdom. If you go via Daniel chapter 2, which is a foot of iron mixed with clay, there is 10 toes there. It's Europe from 476 AD until today. This is the prophet. I wish you can see. Yes, you can see now. So if you go via Daniel chapter 2, you can see this statue. If you go via Daniel chapter 7, you can see this what? This beast. So the head of God is the same with the beast like lion on Daniel chapter 1, chapter 7. From 605 BC to 539 BC, it was Babylon. Then Medo-Persia came to power, 539 BC to 331 BC. Is the same with the chest of what? Of silver. Then in Greece, 331 BC to 168 what? BC. This is the beast like a leopard with four heads. Then Rome came to power 168 BC to 476 AD. So this is the kingdom of the legs of iron. So the days we are living in, according to the prophets, where are we? Let's go to Daniel chapter 2. According to these prophets, where are we now? Daniel chapter 2, verse 43. Daniel 2, verse 43. Daniel 2, verse 43. Let's start from verse 42. And as the toes of the feet were part of iron and part of clay. So God is interpreting now the what? The food. It's part of clay and part of what? Of iron. So it means now we passed on from Babylon, we passed on from Medo-Persia, we passed on from Greece. Now we are in the Rome. We passed on even in the Rome. We're going to understand this. Pagan Rome. Then we went into Papa Rome. To 10 toes. 10 nations of what? Of Rome. Verse 42. And as the toes of the feet were part of iron and part of clay, so the kingdom shall be partly strong and partly broken. Verse 43. And whereas thou sawest iron mixed with mere clay, they shall mingle themselves with the seed of men, but they shall not cleave one to another, even as iron is not mixed with clay. So the Bible is saying what? It's saying in these last days, these 10 toes are 10 kingdoms in this same kingdom. You are going to understand it. They shall try to cleave, they shall try to unite, but they will not what? Unite. Are you understanding this? They shall try to be in unity, but they shall not be in what? In harmony. Are we seeing this today? That the world are rising against what? Nations against what? Nations. Then read verse 44. And in the days of these kings, so it means the feet at what? At the kings. And in the days of these kings shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall not be left to other people, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. So God said, according to these prophets, there shall be another kingdom, the kingdom of who? Of God, which is going to take over all the what? The kingdoms. Because after this, Daniel saw a stone from the mountain. If you go further to verse 5, and the stone had what? The image. So this stone symbolized the kingdom of who? Of Jesus Christ. Let me interpret this dream economically. Today, prophets, pastors, they are promising people about a better future, about a better world, about a peaceful country, about a great economy. When the president of America, when he was campaigning, even today, he was saying that my goal is to make America great again. To make America what? Great again. In what? Economically. To make the world what? Prosper. Not only the president of America, all the presidents, all politicians who are campaigning today is to make the world what? Better. Even the prophets in the churches, they are prophesying to make the country what? Better. But according to the prophets of Daniel in Revelation, the world is not going to be better. It's going to be worse. Why? According to the prophets of Daniel chapter 2, if you study this image, it's a mental image. But as we go with this image, it's decreasing its value. Are you getting it?
Yeah.
It's decreasing its what? Its value. It started with the head of what? Of God. God, it has a great value. Gold, it's a rich metal. Is it true?
Yes.
But we are from gold to what? To silver. Is gold higher than silver?
Yes.
Or less than silver?
Yes.
Is higher than what? Than silver. It means we are decreasing. From silver, we are going to what? To bronze. Is the silver higher than bronze?
Yes.
It's higher than bronze. So it means we are going low and low. Then from bronze to iron. To what? To iron. Then from iron to iron mixed with clay. Do we see where we are going with the economy? So the world is interpreting the prophets of Daniel chapter 2, vice versa. God is saying that we are from gold to clay. But the world is saying we are from clay to gold. It's going what? Vice versa. So those who read must understand where we are at, we are going according to what? To the prophets of Daniel and the prophets of what? Of Revelation. As we are approaching the end time, the coming of Jesus Christ, the economy is going to be worse and worse. Today there are people who think they have money. Actually, they have nothing. Today there is no money. Are we there, God's people?
Yes.
Today there's no what? There's no money. There's only clay and iron. There's no money today. What is money? If you start money, what is the value of money? The real man of money is silver and gold. That is money. In the days of Babylon, money was silver and gold. Man was being weighed on a scale with kgs. To say, you want to buy this kettle. This kettle is worth 5 kg of gold. 5 kg of what? Of gold. That was man in the days of Babylon. Gold was what? All of it. It was easy to find gold. But today, people, they are being cheated. You see, we have given a paper. We are living in the days of clay and what? And iron. They gave you a note of 100 rusa. Then people, they think, I have money. And on that paper, they put a ribbon of gold. If you bend that 100 note, you can have nothing of gold there. You can have what? Nothing. It means it's valueless. You cannot do anything with that man. It's just a paper which have given a value. So people, they think they have money. They have nothing in this day. Money is something which you can use to do something. With gold, you can make jewelry. With gold, you can make some irons to cut other irons, like diamonds. That is the value of what? Of man. Because today, there is no money. The economy is down. They came up with a plan to print papers so that they can put a ribbon of gold. Then they put it value to that paper. Then people work and work and suffer for those papers, which are what? Which are valued. They've just given value with the government, with the authority of the what? Of the world. So today we are living under what? Clay and iron. There's no man today. There's no man today. There's papers. There's what? There's paper. It's where we are living in. So this is the fourth beast of the book of Daniel. This is the beast which we are given warning in Revelation chapter 1, chapter 14, verse 9. This beast, it has a what? It has 10 horns. If you read verse 7 of Daniel chapter 1, chapter 7. And on that 10 horns, Daniel saw a little one rising up from that, from those what? 10 horns. This little one, it comes up after and among the 10 kings of Rome. So those 10 ones of chapter 7, those are at the foot of with 10 toes on chapter 1, chapter 2. So there's more detail in chapter 1, in chapter 7. This little one on that beast, it uproots three what? Three kings. It is different from the previous ones. It shall speak great words against the Most High God. If you read verse 8 of Daniel chapter 7, this little one, it shall speak great words against God who? The Most High. It shall think to change times of the Most High. It shall think to change laws. It shall think to change laws of the what? Of the Most High. It shall persecute the saints of the Most High. Shall for a time and times and divided of what? Of time. It shall persecute what? Christians. It shall rule until the judgment in what? In heaven. We spoke about the judgment. It shall be destroyed by God himself in the time of the what? Of the end. So these are characteristics of this what? Of this beast. In Daniel chapter 8, I consider the horns, and behold, they came up among them another little one. And that little one destroyed three what? Three horns. Verse 24 of Daniel 7. And the 10 horns out of this kingdom are 10 kings that shall arise, and another shall rise after them, and he shall divest from the first, and he shall subdue three kings. So the Bible is saying, on that beast you saw, on that kingdom you saw, which have 10 horns, 10 horns also are ten kings. Which kingdom in the history, which had one king, and it divided into 10 kingdoms? No other than the kingdom of what? Of Rome. Roman Empire divided into what? Into 10 separate nations. Verse 25, and he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change times and laws, and they shall be given unto his hand until a time and half and times and the dividing of times. So these are characteristics of this beast of Daniel and Revelation. Number one, he shall speak words against God, the Most what? High. He shall destroy the saints of God. He shall think to change times and what? And laws. He shall think to change times and what? And laws. God's laws were changed with this what? With this power, with this beast. Daniel 7, verse 25. It shall rule until the judgment of who? Of God. Daniel 7, verse 21, verse 22. This kingdom shall rule until even to the coming of who? of Jesus Christ. This was the story which we were talking about. This kingdom shall rule until to the coming of what? Of Jesus Christ. So now we are going back to the book of Revelation. If you go to the book of Revelation chapter 13, from verse 1, you can see now this beast. It's now all in one in the book of Revelation. In the book of Daniel chapter 2, we saw a beast like a lion. We saw a beast like a leopard. We saw a beast like a bear. But this beast now on Daniel chapter 13 from verse 1, it's all in what? In one. Revelation chapter 13, that beast also in Revelation chapter 13, it rose from the sea. As this beast of Daniel chapter 7 rose from what? The sea. He is a composed beast. He is what? He is four in one. The name of blasphemy is upon what? Is upon this beast. One of his head received a what? A wound, but healed two stages. The whole world wandered after him. The whole world worshipped this what? This beast. This beast speaking great words and blasphemy. As the beast of what? Of Daniel chapter 7. Rule for 42 months. Same time like the beast of what? Of Daniel chapter 7. Make war with the what? The saints. So the beast of Daniel chapter 7 is the same with the beast of Revelation chapter 13. We are connected now. Blasphemy is the name, tabernacle and the angels. He was killed by what? By a sword. So we are going back now to the book of Revelation, chapter 1, chapter 13, verse 1.
And as what? As the Sabbath. This priest of Rome asked the whole world to come with one verse to show him where in the Bible which where when we are commanded to keep Sunday as holy. No one went to this man, but he offered man to give. Even today, they are still offering what? Man to give anyone who can say that in the Bible changed the Sabbath of worship from the seventh day to Sunday only. The Pope has the power to change times. That beast must change what? Times. And what? And laws. The Pope has the power to change times, to abrogate laws, and to dispense with all things, even the precepts of Christ. This beast must change terms and what? And laws. The Pope today is saying he has power to what? To change times and law. This priest writes to the Protestant churches. If Protestants would follow the Bible, they would worship God on the Sabbath day. In keeping the Sunday, they are following a law of the Catholic Church. Sunday worship as the day of worship. It's not biblical. It's a law of the Catholic what? Church. From the Roman Empire to the Pope in the Catholic Church, God was blasphemed. He called himself a God. He called himself the Father of all nations. But God is saying something about it. Brothers and sisters, this is the beast of Daniel and Revelation. The beast of Daniel and Revelation. The kingdom of Rome. From pagan Rome, it went in to papal Rome. That's why it was divided into 10 kingdoms. When it went into papal Rome, it was when Pope was ordained to rule church and what? And state. When his Pope started to rule church and state, he came with his law, which was against the Bible. And Christians were killed in the Roman Empire. That's why the Bible is saying that beast destroyed three kingdoms or three horns. Babylon, Ostrogoths, Visigoths were killed. Vandals and Ostrogoths were what? Were killed. And the Heruli were killed in the 10 nations of Rome. Why they were killed by the command of Pope? Because they were against the teachings of Pope. We went into the time of Dark Ages, whereby people were being persecuted and killed. That's why we have Protestant churches today. Protestant churches, it means the churches were protesting against the Roman Church, Catholic Church. That's why we have a Methodist. John Wesley protested against the Roman Church. That's why we have the Lutherans. Martin Luther protests against church. That's why we have the Baptist. Anna the Baptist protests against the false teaching of the baptism of children and the sprinkling. He protests against those things. We have many people died in time of persecution. John Wesley. All these people, they were being killed in the Roman Empire because they wanted to stand on the word of God. On that time, it was not allowed for you to have a Bible. The Bible was being banned for Christians or people to read the Bible. Only priests and the popes were allowed to read the word of God. That was the time of Dark Ages. That's why the Bible says, this beast killed the what? The saints. My brothers and sisters, it didn't end there. This persecution is coming again. This persecution is coming what? Again. The history is going to repeat itself over the mark of the beast, the image of the beast, and the name of the beast. The persecution we saw in terms of dark ages is going to come again. What is these things? It's about the law of God and the law of church. The kings of the world, they are going to endorse the laws of church, not the laws of who? Of God. Are we going to stand with the laws of the church or the laws of God? In closing, my elder, can we play that video of few seconds? In closing. In closing. It's where we are going with this prophets of Daniel and Revelation. Because of the Roman Church, because of the priests, Pope in Rome, all the world, they are gathered again to go against God, to blaspheme God, to worship the beast of Revelation. As we are speaking, New World Order is in what is in plan. These are the prophets' update. Wait there. There is a transition to what? To new world order, whereby Africa as a continent is going to be what? The part of the transition of the new world order. This is the president of Zimbabwe. I didn't want to go far America or somewhere else. To come closer where we are. Tomorrow I'm going to play another one from here in South Africa. He is saying that the world is going to be in a transition of new what? World order. The new world order is coming. What is it about? What is it about new world order? We are going to start these things tomorrow. I'm inviting you once again.